afternoon.
It's an absolute pleasure to be here this afternoon, because this is something very, very special. many years ago, I was in Las Vegas, sort of a bit bored, and I said, what do I do? So the concierge said to me, what kind of music do you like? And I said, look, you know, I run a radio station, network in Africa, and so I like all kinds of music. Then he says to me, the tickets are finished, but I can get you one Boyz II Men ticket. So I said, really? And he says, yeah. So he got me the ticket, and I went down from the Bellagio to the hotel. And it was probably a 300-person auditorium. Very, very personal, amazing. I mean, the evening for me was the highlight. And at that time, I said to myself, I got to bring these guys to Africa, because the craftsmanship, the harmonies, and just the sense of confidence moving across the stage really impressed me. So for me, it's a real culmination of a dream to really have them here. So I'm just excited, and I'm looking forward to tomorrow, and I'm calling on Kenyans to really dress for the time, because this is a once in a lifetime thing. It's their first time ever in Africa. And for me also, and I can talk briefly about what we envision. For me, to have the greatest boy band of our generation stand on stage is exciting. But I think to have the greatest probably R&B boys band on stage with Africa's greatest boy band is incredible. And when we signed Sauti Soul with Stanbic, and I'll come to talk about the place of Stanbic in just growing the arts, my first thought was, we have to get Sauti Soul on that stage. And at that time, they were on a US trip, on the way, going to the UK, and I called the boys and I said, I don't care what you do, you're gonna break the trip, you're gonna show up, and you're going to do what you really do amazingly well. So, Chief, it's really nice to have you back.
Thanks for having us.
I know we're just waiting.